Hooknall University were demonstrating pre-stressing and post-tensioning in concrete slabs and beams. The tennis racket is a nice example of this. Just like in post-tensioning in a concrete beam, the strings are pulled tightly through, they're wound, and then they're cut. This allows all the tension to go from the strings to the actual racket itself. This way the ball bounces off and the stress is pushed out that way.
I'm about to demonstrate the stress that it's on the strings, how it is converted to the racket, and the ball is forced off.
And there it goes.
It's like a concrete beam in construction. The strands are pulled tight to a certain level of stress. They're cut and they're left in place. The stress here forces the compression to be pushed off to the racket. Same technique that is used on a concrete beam. This is U.S. Army Kevlar jacket. Kevlar is in between the vest. Kevlar is woven into layers, which they're called stress layers. Each layer is responsible for taking a certain amount of compression and pushing it back out. The idea of this vest is that it'll deflect bullets, shrapnel, or anything else that might come into it. Through many layers of Kevlar and many layers of stress, the stress layers actually push out and deflect whatever may penetrate the vest. Same concept of the concrete beam we're reinforcing in the middle. It's just like a flak vest. You have the stress layers pulled tight in the middle. They're woven together but not actually attached, just pulled tight. And they're covered by the vest. Just like a concrete beam, we have the concrete on top with the tendons of the rebar pulled tight in the middle. We're here to demonstrate that the Kevlar vest can take a .44 caliber bullet and still stand up. Ready?
It's good.
Still good.